Hello and welcome to another episode of Join of the Rush. My name is Andreas Sachenko.
And this is Steve Dangle. My arms are stuck like this.
Because we just came back from Ottawa and it's far. Yeah, dude, you're probably gonna need some water to start this episode, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have some of this.
Okay.
Sorry, I forgot to screw this off.
No.
Yeah, man, it was a long drive.
You didn't drive.
Enough with this.
Sorry.
We're good. So the reason we went to Ottawa is that it's actually easier to get tickets to see the Sens play than it is to see the Maple Leafs play in Toronto.
And the Leafs lost 7-0 that night, so worth the drive.
If you're trying that hard to get as far away as possible from that loss, why did you bring your Leafs jersey to the game?
Because shut up. Yeah, everyone was chirping at me saying Leafs suck and all that, and I just point to the standings, where the Leafs are dropping quickly.
There's really one thing I don't understand about the Ottawa Senators, is that why are they called Ottawa Senators? Because first of all, the rink the Senators play at is located in Canada, Ontario, not Ottawa, Ontario.
In the middle of a field.
Well, you've taken a picture of that place, didn't you?
Oh yeah, it's beautiful, you can tell. When I say in the middle of a field, I mean people walking up to the parking lot had to use flashlights to see in front of them. It's a decent arena, decent rink, but across the street there's like cows.
The Ottawa Cows?
That's not a bad team name. Every time they score a goal, the horn goes mmm.
And of course, this building has only bad memories for me. You know what, I could have told you why if you haven't used my glue stick to glue this fake mustache of yours.
It's real, it's just not very good. Growing it for Movember, you're supposed to grow your mustache for the entire month of November and raise money for prostate cancer research.
Luckily, they don't donate based on thickness, otherwise I wouldn't raise very much.
But the trip turned out to be not really bad at all. I mean, we saw a good game between the Buffalo Sabres and the Ottawa Senators with a sixth round of shootout.
And I think we saw our goal of the week.
Out of their own zone, here comes Phillips. In full flight to McCullough. McCullough tries to bust through. Backhander scores! Milan McCullough!
We also got to see our mutual friend, who just so happens to be a big fan of our show, Nikita Filatov, who gave us this as a present. As you can see, it's a wristband in support of Lokomotiv Yaroslavl.
And if you'd like one of these and you want to donate to the families of the players from Lokomotiv, then please go to loveforlokomotiv.com.
Speaking of Filatov, after that game, he got sent down back to the minors.
I think I know why this all happened. Well, see, they called up Filatov in hopes of attracting some superstar attention to Ottawa, like international superstar Andreas Sacheka. But then once we drove home, they were like, ah, let's just send him back.
Even though, as you can plainly see in this clip, he didn't play all that bad.
Puck is knocked down. Here's Filatov, his shot. And that one deflects off the stick of Enroth up into the mesh. Play continues, though. Here's Filatov back in front for Winchester. Gonchar with a shot. That's knocked down. Winchester, he gets a shot and misses.
But does he have a video blog?
You know, maybe the Sens should trade him to Toronto. So, first of all, we could see him more often. And really, the Maple Leafs could use him.
Yeah, totally. They could use him. He has to play in goal, though.
Yeah. Moving on to the biggest news of the week. Obviously, you guys want us to talk about Vitas Chev and the whole thing that happened in Minsk. This is exactly why we're going to talk about Subway Super Series.
What?
We're shooting this episode right before the second game of the Subway Super Series. This is exactly why I'm so happy. Because as for now, we're up 1-0.
Over the Q.
It's part of Canada anyways. It counts. So Team Russia won his first game against the QMJHL 2-0, and Bogdan Patekhin scored one of the goals. And the only reason I'm bringing this up is because these guys tried so hard not to allow him to score. So, you saw that? I mean, seriously, who does that, eh? 2 minutes on Sportsman.
Yeah, whatever, Stripes. But now that we're done talking about the Subway Super Series, I think we should finally talk about the team and the story that everyone wants us to talk about.
The Winnipeg Jets.
Yeah. What?
So this week the Jets lost to the Sabres 5-6. And if you think of their previous results where they would be playing with the Flyers and the score would be 8-9. I mean, no matter how low they are in standings, you gotta admit, they're a fun team to watch.
I like watching the Winnipeg Jets for the same reason I like watching Snakes on a Plane. That movie, much like the Winnipeg Jets, is so bad that it's great.
I didn't see that coming.
I know that the Jets are a bad team. I know that it's sloppy hockey, but it's fun to watch.
Well, what do you think their goalie, Ondrej Pavlic, thinks of that?
Enough is enough! I've had it with these motherfucking goals in this motherfucking net! Everybody strap in. I'm about to go Andrei Nazarov.
Wow, Steve, what a beautiful impersonation of Czech accent!
What? Speaking of Andrei Nazarov, I think that's a perfect segue, so we can talk about
the Blue Jackets trade. So Mark Letestu was traded from the Pittsburgh Penguins to the Blue Jackets of Columbus for a fourth round pick. So yeah, see, what do you think about this trade?
Who cares? Let's talk about Vitas.
So to cut the long story short, Vitas is playing in Dynamo Minsk. He's trailing behind 2-3 late in the third period, pulling the goalie, trying to score a goal.
And naturally, the way you generate scoring chances, starting a fight.
But wait, it only gets better. One fight is it wasn't enough for Vitas. Two would do it.
Ah, Kip Brennan's trying out for a new career in modeling, I see.
Oh, thinking about cricket hockey already? What a smart man.
Oh, I didn't say Kip, he did.
Oh, don't get me wrong, guys. I mean, I have Kip Brennan, Johnny Rustin, Jeremy Blonsky on my NHL 12 team.
Then introducing the star of the show, Andrei Nazarov. Well, I can't read lips in Russian. What were those guys saying?
Oh, I know exactly what they were saying. The game was getting kind of boring anyway, so they talked about movies.
I think Sex and the City was the best movie of all time.
What? No, you're crazy! No, it was the best Sarah Jessica Parker, number one actor of all time. The Sister Under the Traveling Pants was like Citizen Kane, the best movie of our time.
So the outcome of this shenanigan was Kip Brennan got suspended for 4 games, Nick Tomaszewski and Andrei Nazarov were suspended for 2 games, and Artemi Panarin, who also was taking part in the incident, got suspended for 1 game.
Which begs the question, who's left?
So Vitas was forced to finish this game with 5 guys being on the bench, 4 in the ice, and 5 more in the penalty box. So apparently it's more than enough for them.
So did they tie it?
It was this close. Alright, so we're covering a lot of ground today, and really all that's left for us to do is to answer questions. And here's an intriguing question. Why do you guys swap all the time?
I don't know what he's talking about. Sorry, I don't know how to answer that. Any ideas?
No. And of course, your beloved featured Russian word of the day. And this week I'm teaching Steve the word pakhmelye.
Pakhmelye, yeah?
Yeah.
And that means what?
That's the state I was when we were driving from Ottawa.
Oh, so it means hangover.
Well, this is it for this episode of Joining the Russian All Hockey RU. My name is Andreas Sechenko. What the hell is this?
It's a Team Czech Republic jersey because Russia lost in the World Junior A Challenge.
Hang on a sec, I'll be right back. Okay, go on.
And my name's Steve Daniel. See you next time. Oh, you cherry pashka!
So, you saw that? I mean, seriously, who does that, eh? Two minutes on Sportsman.
Whatever, like, whatever.
What else? Yeah, whatevs.